Now we will be calculating velocity, right, in translational and rotational motion, right. So we calculated this one, displacement, general equation of a displacement in translational rotational motion. This is a general equation. P with respect to ground, this is the point P with respect to ground, So displacement of C with respect to ground and the displacement of P with respect to center. Now here P with respect to ground, V center with respect to ground. At all time if you take it as this is V only, V center of mass, it will goes in the straighter direction. That means I can write it as VP with respect to ground is V plus P with respect to C. P with respect to C, this P is always rotating, right? This is rotating. For example, this P will comes to P dash. P with respect to what? C, if you take it as, it is nothing but V is equal to R omega. So here V is equals to R into omega, it is rotating. Point to P with respect to C, that is nothing but R into omega. So PG will be V plus R omega, V plus R omega. Now let us calculate at a different points. So V plus R omega, it will always in the same direction or opposite direction, it depends on that. Now let us take a body is moving in a circular path. Right. Let us make four points here. This is the ground. This is ground. And the particle is here, here, and here. Right? It is rotating. Rotating with angular velocity omega. Rotating with angular velocity omega. Right? At this point, if you take it as the center of mass is always moving with what? Vc. This is a translational velocity, straight direction. Now here, if I draw V, this is a V, rotational, this is nothing but V, this is nothing but what? V. So V is equal to R omega. V is equals to R omega. Here V is equals to R omega. So here V is equals to R omega. 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 So when a body is going in a circular path, this radius is nothing but R. This radius is R. R and what? Omega. When it is going with a constant angular speed. But already one more velocity, this is due to rotation. This is due to what? Rotation. So already due to translation a velocity is there. So if I extend this one, this is nothing but Vc. Am I right? If I extend here, this will be Vc, right? If I extend here, this will be Vc, right? If I extend in this direction, that is nothing but in this direction, this is nothing but Vc, right? Now see, in the first case, both are in the same direction. Now let us make it up. This is point A, this is point B, this is point C, point D. Right? Let us make it up. This is point X circle. Let us make it as this is nothing but C. Otherwise, we will take it as 1, 2, 3. So, no confusion. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? 4 points are there. Now, V is equal to R omega. This is what? Vc. So, V1 is equal to, at that point, if I want to write V1, V1 equals to Vc plus R omega. Vc plus R omega. At that particular point, two velocities are acting in the same direction. But when it travels to a distance of 90 degrees, Vc and R omega both are perpendicular to each other. If I want to write V2 there, V2 both are perpendicular to each other under root of Vc square plus R omega whole square. Am I right? Next, when it comes to at this point, this Vc is in the forward direction, R omega is in the backward direction. So, this is the important point in further classes. So, based on that point only, we will be discussing the further explanations. So, here V3 can be written as V3 V3 can be written as VC minus R omega. If both are equal, it will become what? Zero. Then that is called pure rolling concept will be calling. We will be discussing completely pure rolling another topic for that. Next, V4 if I take it as, again the net force is acting here, net velocity. V4. So V4 is under root of what? VC square plus R omega whole square. Right? So once it was asked in JE entrance question, this is IIT JE 2004. IIT JE 2004. The model you can say it as IIT JE 2004. Particle velocities. Now let us take example we will be taking. So increasing water we have to keep it as. Let us take it is moving with 4 meter per second. Moving with 4 meter per second. Angular velocity omega, angular speed is 3 radian per second. Let us take this radius r is 1 meter. So increasing order or decreasing order of V1, V2, V3, V4. Now V1 is equal to what you get? VC is how much? 4. 4 plus R is 1 into omega, that is nothing but 3, that is nothing but 7 meter per second is the velocity at the topmost point. When it travels from an angle of 90 degrees, V2 equals to net velocity under root of 16 plus 9, which is nothing but root 25, which is 5 meter per second. 5 meter per second. That means as it is coming from top to here, the velocity is gradually decreasing. Next, as it comes here, V3 equals to VC minus R omega. VC is how much? 4 minus 3, which is nothing but 1 meter per second. 1 meter per second. Is it clear this one? 1 meter per second. Next, after that, V4 equal to V4 will be safe as of what? 5 meter per second. So if you want to add in the increasing order, velocity V1 is greater, V1 is greater than V2 or V4, you can keep it as, and greater than what? V3. So like this we will be calculating the velocities at different points. So here only one major concept, when it is taking translational and rotational, always center of mass will travel in straight direction. That's nothing but translational velocity or the linear velocity. Due to rotation, it will give what? Angular velocity. Angular velocity direction will change. Okay. Because the V is equal to R omega, the velocity due to the rotation will change, but the center of mass velocity will not change. That means here the VPG, center with respect to ground, center is always going in which direction? Straight direction. That is nothing but V. P with respect to C. Now this P, this is the P here. This is P with respect to C. Changed P with respect to C. Changed P with respect to C is changed. That is nothing but R omega.